Hello everyone, I am Simarjit Kaur and today we will be discussing the topic of accounting for amalgamations and mergers. Before I start, I would like to introduce three terms with you people. First one is amalgamation. That is when there are two companies, supposedly X company and Y company. Both these companies liquidate and together they form XY company, or you can say it Z company. This is the case of amalgamation. Other term is absorption. Absorption is there are two companies, X company and Y company. When X company takes over the business of Y company, the business, and it continues to operate as X company. Operations will be continued by X company, that is known as absorption. Continuation of operations with this is the meaning that Y company will be non-existent. It shall go into liquidation. Third term is reconstruction. Reconstruction is changing the financial structure of the company. So if a company gets liquidated and then changes its financial structure, it is external reconstruction. And if the company without getting liquidated alters its share capital or reduces its capital, that is the case of internal reconstruction. Coming up to the main topic, that is amalgamation. Amalgamation is of two types. First one is in the nature of merger and second is in the nature of purchase. In the nature of merger, as I discussed, was X company and Y company, and in the nature of purchase is the case of absorption. As per accounting standard 14, we follow both these amalgamations. First, I will be discussing amalgamation in the nature of merger. Merger, as I said, two companies are merging together. So we follow the method of pooling of interests. As per the accounting standard 14, there are five conditions to be fulfilled for amalgamation to be called as amalgamation in the nature of merger. First condition is all the assets of the company whose business is being sold will be taken over by the buying company. Second is without any adjustment in the book values of the assets. Third is the purchase consideration shall be satisfied by making payment in the form of shares. Fourth condition is same business shall be continued. And fifth and the most important condition is that in the new company, that is in XY company or in the Z company, the 90% of the shareholding shall be similar to that it was in the previous company. I have been using two terms, previous company, new company, buying company and the selling company. As per accounting standard 14, we follow two terms, which I'm writing as follows. First one is X company, the company whose business is being sold. Here X and Y company's business is being sold. These are transferor companies and the company to whom the business is being sold is transferee company. So five conditions are very important to be satisfied in amalgamation in the nature of merger. Even if one condition is not satisfied, it becomes amalgamation in the nature of purchase. Coming up, as I said, accounting standard 14 is being followed. All of us know that accounting standard 14 is no longer in existence. In addition to it or in place of it, Indian accounting standard 103 is in practice. So there are certain changes which have been introduced due to introduction of Ind AS 103, which stands for business combinations. As I use the term transferor and transferee, in Indian accounting standard 103, the terms are acquirer and acquiree. The company whose business is being sold or whose the company which is going into liquidation or the company whose business will no longer be into existent are known as acquiree companies. And the companies who is taking over the business of the existing companies shall be known as acquirer companies. Now, another difference is, I have said there are two types of amalgamation, that is in the nature of purchase and in the nature of merger. But as per Indian accounting standard 103, there will only be one type of amalgamation, that is amalgamation in the nature of purchase. Pooling of interests method will no longer be available for usage. acquisition method will be used. Discussing about the acquisition method, you are allowed to make changes in the book value of the assets and liabilities. Assets and liabilities as per Ind AS 103 shall be recorded at fair values or at the values at which the acquirer company has taken over. And those assets and liabilities will be not be recorded in the books of accounts which were not taken over by the acquirer company. Now, the most important condition about is the purchase consideration. So class, purchase consideration. What is the meaning of this term? Any amount in any form payable to the acquiree company by acquirer company is purchase consideration. Purchase consideration can be paid in the form of shares in the new company, that is in the acquirer company, in form of cash, in form of any securities or any other kind. Most important is this, that the purchase consideration will only be paid to the shareholders of the acquiree company and not to debenture holders. Any amount that is payable to the debenture holders or to the trade creditors or to the trade liabilities will not be accounted for as purchase consideration. It will just be a discharge of liability on behalf of acquiree company. Purchase consideration can be calculated by four methods. First method is lump sum. Without bothering about the amount of assets and liabilities available with the transferer company or the acquiree company, as we say according to the new term, an amount is fixed that acquiree company shall only be paid that fixed amount without bothering about the value of assets and liabilities. Next is net worth. Net worth method, any worth of the business is total assets minus third party liabilities. Third party liabilities means liabilities which are due to the outsiders. That is the worth of the business. Any amount payable, assets minus third party liabilities. Any amount, supposedly I take an example, assets were of 6 lakh and third party liabilities is 1 lakh. Resultant figure is 5 lakh. Any amount paid in excess of 5 lakh will be for the goodwill which is carried by the acquiree company, and any amount below 5 lakh will be accounted as a capital reserve for the acquirer company because it is paying less than what it is due. Third method is net payment method. We are not bothered about the assets and liabilities available with the acquiree company. We are just fixing that in these many forms, certain forms of payment. First one is shares, then securities, cash or any other kind. And last method is class, swap ratio method. Swap ratio method, or you can say intrinsic value method. What is the intrinsic value of the shares? Any amount which is available for the equity shareholders after having made payment to debentures for the tax and also after preference dividend divided by the number of equity shares which are available with the company. This will be the intrinsic value of the shares, or you can say the backing of over which the company in future shall earn certain amount of profit. After having calculated intrinsic value, the shares of the transferer company will be valued at that, and according will be valued at that intrinsic value, and accordingly purchase consideration shall be calculated. We are taking one example of it. There are two companies, X company and Y company. It has share capital of rupees 6 lakh and rupees 2 lakh divided into equity shares of rupees 10 each. For the purpose of amalgamation, intrinsic value is calculated as follows. Intrinsic value is rupees 15 and intrinsic value for Y is rupees 10. So rupees 20. So while calculating purchase consideration, 6 lakh divided by 10 is 60,000 is the number of equity shares. So 60,000 into 15, that is 9 lakh. and 20,000 into 20 will be 4 lakh. So total purchase consideration payable to X and Y company is 9 plus 4 lakhs. Thank you so much.